attenuators, we can also call it as ferrite attenuators, or you can see here. So whenever we have already seen the microwave bend setup, whenever we are dealing with the microwave bend setup, after the isolator, the block what we have is an attenuator. That can be our variable attenuator or a fixed attenuator. I will tell you what is the difference between both of them. Okay, so attenuator is also one of the ferrite device which is used for transmission of the microwave signal among the bend setup or the among the whole microwave setup. Okay, so these, similarly, as we have discussed earlier, ferrite devices will be attenuating the signal. So again, here also attenuators is a ferrite attenuator which will attenuate particular microwave frequency and pass it unaffected. Okay, so whatever the microwave signal is transmitting through this bend setup, okay, it will again get attenuated here. Isolator degra, it will be transmitting in a single direction with a small amount of attenuation. Remaining, if at all there is any huge radiation, or if at all there is overload or some what kind, that it will be again attenuated at the attenuator level. Okay, so attenuator is nothing but it will take the input from the isolator. It will take the microwave signal as an input from the isolator, as the diagram is showing, and it will attenuate the signal, where attenuation is nothing but it makes the quality of the signal to remain same, but the power of the signal will be reduced such that there won't be any radiation. And the specialty of this attenuator is, if at all there is overload, okay, it will also attenuates the signal in such a way that if at all there is overload, it will be reduced. Okay, so a ferrite attenuator will attenuate the microwave frequency which is passing through it, okay, and that passing frequency will not be affected, but only the power will be reduced. Okay, so this attenuator, as we have seen the bend setup, it will be between the klystron tube as well as load, somewhere here in this place. Okay, so these attenuators are of two types. One is fixed attenuators, second one is variable attenuators. Okay, fixed attenuators, what do you mean by fixed attenuators? Whenever we are using a fixed attenuator, okay, only a fixed amount of attenuation is provided. Okay, and whenever we are using a variable attenuator, we can alter the attenuation. Okay, I will give you a small example. See, there is a fan in a room and there is no regulator at all. By default, the fan is connected with a speed of 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 readings untai kada. Okay, so it is connected with a speed of 5. As there is no regulator at all, whenever you switch on that particular fan, it will obviously move in a 5 speed. Okay, or it will rotate in a 5 speed. That is nothing but fixed regulation. Similarly, whenever you are going for a fixed attenuator, this one, okay, the power, amount of power reduced will be fixed. A particular fixed attenuator enta power reduced cheyadaniki design chesaro, obviously anta power reduce aipothadi. Okay, and coming to the second example, variable attenuators, let us take our fan has got a switch kind of thing with a regulator. So according to our requirement, we can change the speed of the fan. Okay, similarly, if at all you are using a variable attenuator, whatever the microwave signal is passing through that, we can vary the power, or we can vary the attenuation of that particular incoming microwave signal. Manaki enta power tagginchukovalo anta power matrame we can also attenuate that. Okay, similarly, see here, generally a microwave bend setup will be consists of a variable attenuator. So here you can see this particular little fellow is our variable attenuator. Attenuators are of two types. One is fixed attenuator, one is variable attenuator. If at all you are going for a fixed attenuator, okay, the power will be automatically reduced according to the fixed reading of that particular attenuator. Okay, whereas if at all you are going for a variable attenuator like this, you can, user who is using this bend setup can alter the attenuation. మనకి ఎంత పవర్ రెడ్యూస్ అవ్వాలి అనుకుంటున్నామో అంత మాత్రమే వీ కెన్ రెడ్యూస్ బేస్డ్ ఆన్ దిస్ పర్టికులర్ రీడింగ్ ఆర్ వేరియబుల్ రీడింగ్. ఓకే, సో అటెన్యుయేషన్ ఈజ్ వన్ ఆఫ్ ద ఇంపార్టెంట్ పాయింట్ ఆర్ ఎన్ ఇంపార్టెంట్ ప్రాసెస్ ఇన్ ఏ మైక్రోవేవ్ సిగ్నల్ ట్రాన్స్మిషన్. ఈవెన్ దో ఐసోలేటర్ ఈస్ ప్రొవైడింగ్ మినిమమ్ అటెన్యుయేషన్ ఓకే, the main aim of an isolator is to transmit the signal only in one direction, but what about the remaining radiation or the overloading mechanism? There comes the concept of our attenuator, where our incoming microwave signal will be attenuated, where attenuation means quality of the signal remains same. Manam entaithe bandwidth kani lekapothe entaithe amplitude tho pampisthunnamo that quality of the signal won't be affected. Only the power present in that particular signal will be suppressed, such that there won't be any overloading as well as there won't be more radiation. Okay, that is the main purpose of attenuation. If at all we are going to labs, you can see an attenuation measurement of attenuation also in that particular lab practical. Okay, so we will be having two types of attenuators. One is fixed attenuation, one is variable attenuation. Fixed attenuation means whatever that attenuator is fixed for, that power will be reduced of an incoming microwave signal. Whereas variable attenuation means a user can alter the attenuation according to the requirement. Okay, enta power tagginchukovalo, you can alter that particular this thing. Okay, so attenuators are mainly, it avoids overloading as well as radiation. Okay, so attenuator is placed between the microwave source and the load, as you have already seen in the Benn setup. So microwave source and load madhyalo attenuator untundannaru.